Gotcha.
The Mighty Bow Jewel continues to be an essential part of high-damage bow builds, allowing the bow to reach a final level of charge that significantly increases your damage output. Sadly, in Iceborne, there are still no good armor sets that provide Mighty Bow in an efficient way, which means you're forced to run bow builds without it until RNGesus decides you've suffered enough and he blesses you with your first Mighty Bow decoration. Now, as you guys know, I live stream a lot of Monster Hunter World on a near daily basis, and probably the most common question I'm getting in my live chat is, how do I obtain the Mighty Bow decoration more easily? And that's the question we're setting out to get an answer to today. I never really know how to answer it when I'm live because I've unlocked this decoration so long ago and so many times without thinking about it. However, I've gone ahead and done some research, and I'd like to go ahead and share my findings with you guys. So, if it feels like the Mighty Bow Jewel is pretty rare, that's because it is. According to Kiriniko's decoration drop rate tables, the Mighty Bow is only coming from worn face stones and warped face stones. So face stones, for those of you who really don't know what these are those pretty rewards you receive at the end of an investigation. Additionally, the drop rate is only 0.27% from worn face stones, and a slightly better drop rate of just 0.68% with the warped face stones. So that's a quarter of 1% and just over half of 1% respectively. That's really, really, really rare. And that's kind of how decorations work in Monster Hunter World. Most of the valuable decorations have a bad drop rate like that. And in fact, there are ones with even worse drop rates than this. Now, what I found most curious about this table is that it does show the Mighty Bow not dropping from any other kind of decoration, which means the new level 4 face stones in Iceborne are making it harder for new players to obtain the Mighty Bow. In the past, in the base game, you would have received worn face stones from doing end game activities. However, in Iceborne, you're going to receive mostly carved face stones and sealed face stones, neither of which drop Mighty Bow. Basically, what I'm saying is that the new decoration loot table is kind of squeezing out the old decoration table. There's not enough room. So your odds are actually probably lower now, because we talked about the drop rate when you have a warped face stone and a worn face stone, but we also have to talk about your odds of actually getting a warped face stone and a worn face stone. Now you're mostly going to be getting these new level 4 face stones. What I found crazy is that the Mighty Bow isn't even the only decoration having this issue. The Guard Up decoration also only drops from older decorations from the base game. So if you're a new player going after the Guard Up decoration, you're probably feeling the same frustration at how long it's taking to unlock. At least you have the Urgon armor set in Master Rank, which is not so bad. You know, it's two pieces of the armor set, and it pretty much contributes toward a decent set. It's not like an awesome set, but it's not terrible either. Okay, but let's go ahead and get to the point of this video. Let's move on from that. Knowing the Mighty Bow decoration is coming from warped face stones, how can we farm for those decorations faster? And I found that there were multiple answers to this question. So the best answer was the same one I was already giving out. If you want the fastest method of obtaining warped face stones, then you'll want to wait for the festivals to roll around. You know, there's a festival every about month, 2 months. And then you're going to farm warped face stones in the high rank event quest. It's high rank, okay? High rank event quest titled The Name's Lavasiath. That's the name of the quest. It's an event quest. This quest was released later in the base game to help players obtain rare decorations. You're probably going to find this boring and probably annoying because you have to go back to high rank and farm a high rank monster who, he's not even that popular. People don't like Lavasiath for some reason. I like Lavasiath. Now, on the other hand, your master rank weapons should be making this fight pretty fast and it should be pretty easy to take him down. So that's the nice part. You're not fighting a master rank monster. You're fighting a high rank monster with master rank weapons. It should be easy, guys. Come on. So another thing, sometimes during a festival, half of the festival will offer the names Lavasiath, and then after like a week, maybe 2 weeks, the other half of the festival will offer the Greatest Jagras, or vice versa, you know, maybe in the other order. I already know the question you're going to be asking me is, should I farm the Greatest Jagras if the names Lavasiath is not available yet during the festival, and is kind of hard to say. The problem with the worn face stones, we saw the drop rates. The worn face stones are just a little less than half the drop rate of the warped face stones. So if he was spitting up literally twice the number of warped face stones you would get from Lavasiath, then yeah, go for the greatest Jagras. But you have other methods of farming for this warped face stone or for the mighty bow. Let's go ahead and keep talking about that. Actually, let's talk about one that I'm not so sure you should be doing. So we have that new option that we received in one of the previous festivals called Guild Alchemy. This is with the Elder Melder, and somebody's going to be like, hey, Game Economist, why don't we just do Guild Alchemy? Silver melding tickets. So I did research on this. Once again, going back to Kiraniko's drop rates for the decorations, if he's telling, you know, if he's accurate, he's saying that only warped and worn face stones drop the mighty bow. Only warped and worn face stones. Now, I was doing research on silver melding tickets. Obviously, the gold alchemy tickets will not give, you know, a level 2 decoration. Those are all level 4. But the silver alchemy does. However, I was reading that the silver melding tickets are only giving decorations from the carved face stone loot table. And the problem here is carved face stone loot table, that's an iceborne loot table, and it, you know, doesn't include warped face stones, right? Warped face stones are their own decoration. So if all of that information is correct, you will never receive Mighty Bow from the Guild Alchemy method of farming for decorations. And that means you're probably going to jump over to the name's Lavasiath, and if you don't have that, maybe the greatest Jagras. Now let's move on to another condition. Let's say there's no festival. What do you do if there's no festival and you want to farm for the Mighty Bow? Well, if you're dead set on only spending all of your time going after the Mighty Bow as efficiently as possible, then you're probably still going to go back to high rank and you're going to farm Tempered Elder Dragons. If you can't farm Tempered Elder Dragons because you don't have the investigations, you would then alternatively probably want to start out with the Arch-Tempered Elder Dragons, who also happen to give Warped Face Stones, but they also give you these Stream Stones. Remember Stream Stones? Oh my gosh, it's been a while. The Elder Melder does have this thing called the Strange Stream. You guys know about the Strange Stream is where you give up all your Stream Stones and your high commendations, and these get turned into, guess what? Warped Face Stones. So you can get some other Warped Face Stones from the Elder Melder that way. Maybe if you're real lucky, one of them turns into Mighty Bow. Once you've fought some Arch-Tempered Elder Dragons for a while, you can check your investigations, see if you have any good Tier 2 or Tier 3 monsters tempered in high rank that are giving, you know, maybe 4 to 5 rewards out. Purple rewards, right? Tempered rewards. You don't want to go lower than Tier 2. Tier 2 will give you the Warped Face Stones. Tier 3 will also give you the Warped Face Stones, and it'll give you some of those. It'll give you some of those stream stones that you can trade with the Elder Melder. So that's going to be the next best method of farming for the Mighty Bow if you do not have access to a festival. All right, and those are the primary methods that I'm going to be recommending. There is one more thought I have about farming for the Mighty Bow, and that's you could just continue to play Iceborne and not really worry about it, and just do whatever you were already going to do. Focus on some other area of farming. Keep fighting monsters. And the thing is, in Iceborne, it's not that you never receive warped face stones, you just receive them at a lower, smaller rate. Okay, so if you wanted to just optimize getting warped face stones, that's why you would go back to high rank. But you actually do receive them in Iceborne, in master rank. So if you just keep playing, eventually you will receive one. So the reason why this is important to think about is because there might be other, maybe level 4 decorations that you actually need and that will benefit you sooner than just going after Mighty Bow. So, you know, there's bottlenecks for the best decorations in the game. It's not just Mighty Bow you need, it's whatever these best decorations. I need to create a list, actually, is what I need to do. I need to make a list of the best decorations. That's clickable, right? People would click on that. The best decorations in Iceborne. Anyways, yeah, so there's some rare decorations in Iceborne that you get from the sealed face stones as well. They have really abysmally low drop rates, too. And if you were to just go after those, you might pick up Mighty Bow on the way. It's just something to think about, anyways. It would be sad if you spent a lot of time in high rank, never got the Mighty Bow, just wasted tons of hours, and then you're just still in the same spot that you always were in Iceborne when you could have actually been farming Iceborne that whole time. Something to think about, especially if you haven't reached Master Rank 100 and finished unlocking everything in the Grinding Glands, because in high rank, you do not level up your Master Rank, okay? And that's it. In the meantime, while you're working on that, maybe I'll work on a guide that shows off the most effective bow builds that you can use without Mighty Bow in the build. Would you be interested in this? Let me know. If you want to show your appreciation on the video, you know, leave a like, do the typical stuff that YouTubers tell you to do. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.